My friends, Mommy and Amelia here. She's been taking a little nap, so maybe she'll wake up. Hi, sweet girl. Hi, guys. We're home. I think the last time I picked up the camera was the day she was born, which is now 4 days ago. She's 4 days old. We got discharged from the hospital after 2 days, and we've been home for 2 days. 2 + 2 = 4. Oh man, oh man. I'm gonna try to rest my arm on my knee. If the bun is any indication, y'all, it's been rough goings over here. So, just wanna be honest with how recovery's been going and how these past few days have been going. It's been tough. It's been really tough. It's been very reminiscent of my healing process and journey with after Hugo's birth. Definitely a little bit of like trauma and flashbacks to that recovery this go around, and like sleep too has been a little more reminiscent of that time. Luckily I feel good. Like I feel very on par with how I felt. I wouldn't say I felt like hormonally I was on like a bit of a high after Theodore was born, and this time I don't feel like that quite that much of a high, but I feel a little more, I feel even, which is good. I mean, where to even start? I've been telling people that like I can deal with newborn sleep, which is like all over the place and rough. She does not like to be put down on her back. She does not like to sleep in the bassinet. She does not like to sleep in the Dock-a-Tot. She does prefer to be upright, like a more inclined position. She does have like a lot of, she spits up a bit, and she, like, you can just hear like in her tummy that there's like a lot of things going on. And so I kind of feel like, sorry, I'm just trying to like get my arm comfortable. I kind of feel like there's, you know, like that's why she prefers to be on an incline, so that she can digest it. When she does spit up, that it is a more comfortable position for her. So yeah, that, I mean, that's been tough during the night. And then she does prefer to be like sleeping on me and on someone. I can deal with that. I can deal with the C-section recovery. I can deal with breastfeeding and like all of the nipple trauma. But dealing with all of those things all at once has been really, really tough. Breastfeeding has been horrendous this time. Like, things were seemingly going well in the hospital, and like that's, you know, when it comes to my breastfeeding journey, if you know anything about like the other times I breastfed the boys in the hospital, things always seem to be going fine. I get checked by all the lactation consultants, all the nurses, everyone's like, that looks great, that looks great. The pediatrician this go around did say, oh, she has a little bit of a tongue tie, but like it shouldn't be any like too big of an issue. And then I get home, and like a day after I get home, my nipples are torn up, sore, bleeding, cracked, scabbed, like all of the above. And it's just so frustrating because it's like, this is my third go around. This is my third go around. And like, we're still dealing with this, and like this is still a thing, and like they're, and I get like every feeding journey is different, but like my nipples are still the same. And it's so frustrating that like, try this, okay, I try it, it doesn't work. Try this, okay, I try it, it doesn't work. And like, this is the earliest, so I've moved over to exclusively pumping, and we've been feeding her my pump breast milk from a bottle, which like has been working just fine for now. It doesn't feel like it's a sustainable option long term with 30 kids, with like just like the busyness of our lives. How precious is she? Oh my goodness. But like for now, with Jeff home on paternity leave and like with help and stuff, like it's doable. But like, oh my gosh, even where was I going with that? Even like pumping was hurting in the beginning. Now it's like not quite as painful, but like it's just, it's so much. So I spoke with a lactation consultant from the hospital who called, I think it was yesterday, to check in, which was really sweet. And she gave me some, she told me to get the Silverette cups, which I did. I ordered them on Amazon. She told me to get something called Medi Honey, which is like an Anuka honey. She used like a bunch of cool words. It's like from Australia. It's like a medical ointment that really quickly relieves like burn, trauma, or like scab, cracked, all that stuff. So she said like those two things plus using like warm salt water should really help to heal my nipples. And then she was like, call us if you need anything. She gave me their number. Yeah, it's just, I mean, that aside has been, oh, what was I was gonna say, this has been the earliest that I've ever had to transition to pumping or like to another source. This is the earliest. Does that make sense? My brain is a bit jumbled. But like, whatever. Also, I'm trying like not to like, I'm trying to roll with the punches a little more this pregnancy, obviously, because I've got other kids. We've got like a lot of stuff going on, and like, I'm trying not to make myself crazy with like, oh my God, I have to breastfeed and we have to do this and we have to like, we will figure it out and we're gonna figure out a feeding solution. And like, it might look different in 3 weeks. It might look different in 6 weeks. And like, it's just gonna be about adjusting to like what our family needs, and like where we are as a unit. So there you go, there's that. My C-section recovery this go around, and this is like not to scare anyone who is having a repeat C-section or a C-section in general, is so much worse. It's so much more painful, so much worse than it was last time, which like blows my mind a little bit, because I'm like, I get it. This has been such a lesson in like, you can do the same thing twice and like, they're gonna be two different experiences. And like, she is so different than both Hugo and Theodore were, which again is just a lesson in like, you can have multiple kids and like, each one is gonna be different. And like, some things might be the same, but like, you can't go into it expecting the exact same journey, which I guess like to a certain extent I kind of figured like, oh, she'll either be like Hugo or she'll be like Theodore, because I felt like they were on opposite ends of the spectrum when it came to like sleep and feeding. And you know, my experiences healing after both births were like night and day. The trauma and like just how horrible the birthing experience was after I gave birth to Hugo, and the recovery and how tough that was versus like how seemingly easy it felt after the C-section with Theodore, and like how quickly I felt like I was on my feet and how like pain-free I was in comparison. Anyway, this sort of falls in between, I guess. And it's been rough. So in the hospital, again, in the hospital, I felt great. They kept asking, oh, what's your pain on a scale from 0 to 10? And I was like a 1. And they granted, yes, I was getting like Torvadol, and I was getting Motrin. But then they I did all the doses, and then they were like, okay, like, are you good on just Tylenol and Motrin? And I was. So we came home, and all of a sudden, like, my incision started burning, like, just burning pain. And luckily, like, there's been no swelling, there's been no redness, there's been no leakage. Like, the incision itself looks really great, which is good. It's just been so much more painful this recovery. I don't know if it's because it's a repeat C-section, is it because they like sliced open the same area? I don't know. All I know is that like, I was not in this much pain last time, and like, I've definitely felt like a little more immobile this go around, which is, again, when you layer that on top of the pain from breastfeeding and the like the pain of not sleeping, it's like this is where the cup runneth over, friends. So I've had a few moments in the past couple of days where I'm like, oh my gosh, how this feels very overwhelming. And like, I think people would assume that like, oh, the most overwhelming part, like, of course you're gonna be overwhelmed, you have 3 kids and like, it's so much. But it's like, not even the 3 kids part that is overwhelming, because the boys have been angels. Like, they have been angels with their baby sister. They've adjusted so incredibly well. I'm sure they'll have their moments, but like, it's been heaven with them. Like, they've been so amazing, they're so understanding. That's not been the overwhelming part. The overwhelming part is just like navigating the newborn stage, which I guess, in like, because I felt like Theodore's newborn stage was so easy. Like, I guess I had a little bit of like newborn amnesia, and like when it came to like how hard the newborn stage can be. And so yeah, I mean, what's great is that Jeff is home and I do have help, and like we're navigating it all together. She is a little angel, and like we have her first doctor's appointment today. She eats out of the bottle super well. There was like no issues with that, which is great. It's just so much, like so much. And I guess in a weird way, I forgot about all of that, and like just forgot how hard the newborn stage is. And I'm sorry that I didn't vlog like baby's first 24 hours and leaving the hospital and her meeting the boys for the first time. Like, it started to feel like a lot in the hospital, and I really wanted to honor just like my intuitive desire to like just chill in the hospital and just take a break. And I think I knew in the back of my head, like, it's gonna be a lot when we get home, you know, with the kids and with the house. Like, let me just take advantage of like doing nothing here and just resting and recuperating. And I'm glad I did, because, you know, the house stuff, like, it's fine, everything will get done, but it's like just my body is not healing as quickly as it did the last time, and it's definitely not responding to all of this in a way that feels encouraging. In a way that feels like, ah, yes, like, you know, today, yes, my scar, 4 days post C-section, my scar is like, it's starting to feel a little bit better. I'm keeping up on the medicine and stuff, but it's still like definitely not, I'm not where I guess I thought I would be. And there's like a little bit of patience there too that I'm lacking in having like grace with myself and just this whole process. But y'all, it's been rough. It's been tough. It's been tough and rough. But I wanted to give you that update so that you know like where we are and what's going on. And here's the little bean. She's a perfect girl. I am, I'm going to do a little work now on the computer. Jeff took Hugo to camp this morning, and he took Theo with him. And so, I got a little quiet time this morning with Amelia. Did also want to mention that although things are really tough, and I wanted to be honest and didn't want to sugarcoat anything, there are so many wonderful, beautiful things about the newborn stage that like you just completely forget. I think one of the big ones is just all the like quiet bonding that you get with your newborn, and how like they just want to be near you and on you, and like that is so special and like so specific to this little stage. And I know I'm gonna blink, she's gonna be going to kindergarten, so I'm trying to, you know, keep everything in perspective. Yeah. I'll keep you guys updated. I'll vlog like when and how I can. I'm sorry that this is like not a traditional vlog style, but I feel like I'm not yet in a place mentally and like physically especially where that is a feasible option for me, because like it's just so much. Thank you guys for all your love and support. I love you all, and yeah, we'll see you in our next one. Bye, friends.